Martin Scorsese has produced many great films like Taxi Driver, Goodfellas, Wolf of Wall Street, but there are some of his masterpieces as well which didn't get the recognition they deserved, and After Hours is on top of that list. Hello everyone, my name is Varun and this is my channel ID Filk, and today we are going to talk about a very underrated film, After Hours. When I first saw After Hours, I was very much impressed by the film and wondered why it didn't fare well when it released way back in 1985. The film is a story told wonderfully with plenty of entertaining moments in it without being preachy or pretentious. After Hours is a story of a word processor named Paul Hackett, played by Griffin Dunne. He meets Marcy at a coffee shop one night, who is played by Rosanna Arquette. Later that night, when Paul calls Marcy, she invites him for a date at a friend's house. Paul agrees and he says he will be there in the next 45 minutes. But that begins the ordeal of a worst night of Paul's life. He goes through some unpleasant experiences, like being broke for the entire night, to being chased down by a mob who wants to kill him for a crime that he didn't commit. There are various such instances in the film when you feel sorry for Paul, who is desperately trying to reach back his home. But the events included in all the scenario are so bizarre that it keeps you glued to the screen, with a bit of humor attached to each scene. The film is made with the sheer brilliance of director Martin Scorsese and writer Joseph Menin. Joseph wrote this film as a thesis at his film school, and he wouldn't have thought at that time that Scorsese will be directing his script. But the writing is so wonderful, and that is why Scorsese became interested in it. The film focuses on a single night, but there is lots of action and drama attached to it. There are several wonderful scenes in the film, like Paul falling short of the ticket fare at the metro station due to the increase in the fare on the same night. The encounters of Paul and other characters in the film were completely enjoyable. In fact, the romance between Paul and Marcy was handled fine as well, without making it cheesy and boring. Apart from the genius script, it is the magic of Scorsese which makes this film a great. He applied a realistic approach to the film, and you can feel it by the atmosphere created by him. The roads, the buildings, the sets, everything gives you a feel that it is really late at night. As the situation of Paul being invited by Marcy, a girl he just met few hours ago, is not normal. And we can feel it by the mannerisms of Paul, as he is excited about all this, but there is a suspicion of Paul about Marcy, which starts getting become stronger as they visit the nearby coffee shop, and when Marcy starts telling him about her past. Though the ending of the film is visually straightforward, but audience can make assumptions about it. One could be that Paul coming out of that sculpture looks like he is reborn, and he has left all the troubles from the previous night behind. But yet, he is back to his normal but boring office life. Elements like $20 bill, paper and cheese paperweights, the plaster of Paris sculptures, the suicides, keeps you inferring about these items and situations as well. The cinematography of the film complements the terrific screenplay. There are several incredible shots in the film with superb camera movements. The editing is gritty without any dull moments. The decision to bring down the duration to 97 minutes, 45 minutes shorter than the first cut, was a smart one. This style of editing and cinematography could be seen in Scorsese's later films like Goodfellas and Casino. Talking about acting of the film, Griffin Dunne as the lead of the film was perfectly cast. His expressions and mannerisms were spot on. From being a confident person who is going on a date to a nervous individual who is just trying to save his life was perfectly essayed by him. After watching this performance, you will wonder why he didn't get more meatier roles and offers. Rosanna Arquette looked beautiful, and you will be surprised by her short but flawless performance. Other small roles by Linda Fiorentino, Terry Gare, Catherine O'Hara and Will Patton were played fine as well. So After Hours is an immensely enjoyable film which you can watch it multiple times without getting bored. It is a film where many situations arise which are unlikely to happen in a certain individual's life. But due to the authentic treatment of the film, they look relatable, entertaining as well as unique. Though the film did not work well at the time of its release, but now it has garnered an audience and has gained a cult status. Hence, if you have not watched After Hours yet, then I recommend watching it. Also, if you have enjoyed the review, then please press the like button below and subscribe to the channel for more such videos. Thanks for watching and take care.